Good morning, students. Today we will be performing the qualitative organic analysis of given organic sample. This experiment actually consists of three parts. The first part is we will do the preliminary investigation of the given organic sample. The second part will be the detection of elements, which will be performed by preparing the Lesayens filtering. The third part will be the detection of functional groups present in the organic molecule. So, students, let's start with our experiment. Good morning, students. Today we will be carrying out the qualitative analysis of a given organic sample. So, the first sample that we have been provided is this. So, we will start with the preliminary investigation. So, the first test for preliminary investigation is color test. So, as you can see, the given organic sample is white in color. Now, we will do the appearance test, the physical appearance test. As you can see, the organic sample is crystalline in form. After this, we will carry out the solubility test. For that, we will take little bit of the organic sample in a test tube and then add the first solvent, that is cold water. As you can see, the organic sample is not at all soluble in cold water. So, we will proceed to the second solvent, that is hot water. For this, we will warm the water in a Bunsen burner. As you can see, the organic sample is not soluble in hot water too. Now, we will proceed to the third solvent, that is dilute HCl. As you can see, the organic sample is not soluble in dilute HCl2. So, we will proceed to the next solvent. Now, we will test the given organic sample in NaOH. As you can see, the given organic sample is very partially soluble in and dilute NaOH solution, but it is not completely soluble. So, now we will proceed to the last solvent, that is ethanol. As you can see, the given organic sample is completely soluble in ethanol. So, what we will do is, for the rest of the test, we will take the alcoholic solution of this organic sample. So, now we will do the aromaticity test for the given organic sample. For that, I have taken little bit of the sample on a spatula and then I will burn it on the Bunsen burner. As you can see, sooty fumes and flame has evolved. So we can say that the given organic sample is aromatic in nature. Now, we will do the test for answer solution. For that, I will take little bit of the organic sample solution and then I will add alkaline KMnO4, that is Baer's reagent, to the organic sample. As you can see, the KMnO4 color is not being decolorized. So we can confirm that the given organic sample is saturated in nature. Now we will prepare the Le Cyan filtrate for the detection of elements. For that, I have taken little bit of sodium metal in a fusion tube or ignition tube, dried it, and then we will little bit melt it. We will add the given organic sample and then we will burn it to red hot condition. Once it is completely burned and turned red hot, I will put it into a porcelain basin containing cold water. We will repeat the process 2-3 times so that some ample amount of the sample is being formed in the Le Cyan filtrate. And then we will boil it. After boiling, we will cool it, filter it. So now we will carry out the test for nitrogen. For that, we will add 2 ml of Le Cyan filtered in a test tube and then I will add freshly prepared ferrosulfate solution 1 ml and then we will boil it. After boiling, we will cool it under tap water. After boiling and cooling the mixture, we will add dilute sulfuric acid to the reaction mixture. As you can see, no Prussian blue coloration is observed. So we can confirm that the given organic sample do not contain nitrogen. Now we will do the test for halogen. For that, I will take 1 ml of Le Cyan filtrate. To that, I will add HNO3, dilute HNO3, that is nitric acid, 1 ml. After this, we will boil it and cool it. After boiling and cooling the mixture, we will add silver nitrate solution to that. As you can see, the given mixture doesn't form any white precipitate or any precipitate of any color, which confirms that the given organic sample do not contain any halogen. Now we will carry out the test for sulfur. For that, I will take 2 ml of Le Cyan filtered in a test tube and then I will add lead acetate solution to it. As you can see, there is no color formation, especially black, which confirms that the given organic sample do not contain sulfur. So now we will proceed to the detection of functional groups. For that, the first functional group that we will detect is the carboxylic acid group. For that, we will carry out 2 tests. The first test is the litmus test. To carry out the litmus test, I will take little bit of the alcoholic solution of the given organic sample and dip a blue litmus paper to the given solution. As you can see, the blue litmus paper has turned red. This confirms that the given organic sample contains carboxylic acid group. So now we will carry out the confirmatory test using sodium bicarbonate solution. For the sodium bicarbonate test, we will take alcoholic solution of the given organic sample and add saturated bicarbonate solution to the given test tube. The occurrence of brisk effervescence, as you can see, brisk effervescence confirms that the effervescence is of carbon dioxide and the given organic sample contains carboxylic acid group. So now we will do the test for phenolic OH group. For that, I have taken alcoholic solution of the provided organic sample and I will add neutral ferric chloride solution to that mixture. As you can see, no purple violet coloration has been formed. This infers that the given organic solvent doesn't contain phenolic OH group. As the phenolic OH group is absent, we will not carry out the Lieberman nitroso test, which is the confirmatory test for phenolic OH group. So now we will do the test for carbonyl group detection. For that, I will take 2 ml of organic sample solution and to that I will add 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine, that is Brady's reagent. As you can see that no yellow BPT has been formed. This infers that the given organic sample doesn't contain carbonyl group. As the test for carbonyl group has been found negative, so we will not go for the test for aldehyde group and the ketone group. So now we will do the test for alcoholic OH group. For that, I have taken 1 ml of the organic sample and sample solution, and to that I will add 1 ml of ceric ammonium nitrate solution. As you can see, no pink coloration has been formed. This confirms that the given organic sample doesn't contain alcoholic OH. As no elements were detected in the Lassaigne's filtrate test, so the test for nitrogen containing groups, that is the aromatic amine group and aromatic nitro group, has not been performed. So now we can conclude in the result that the given organic sample is aromatic, saturated, and it contains only the carboxylic acid functional group. Moreover, we can say that the given organic sample doesn't contain any elements as tested by the Lassaigne's filtrate test.